I'm Daniele Metilli. I'm a graduate fellow at ECCNR, the National Research Council of Italy. And my colleague is Chiara Paolini from KU Leuven in Belgium. The study we're presenting today is about non-binary gender identities in Wikidata. The idea for this study, for this work, came to us after reading previous studies about the gender gap in Wikidata and Wikipedia and other Wikimedia projects, but especially the work by Maximilian Klein, who published a few papers about this very topic, looking especially at the gender gap between representation of men and women in these projects. Of course, there is also a significant gender gap in the community itself, which is another issue. Our idea is to look at non-binary gender identities, so gender identities that fall outside the gender binary man-woman, and how this can be modeled in Wikidata. Also, how they have been modeled in the past. The motivation for this work comes from the fact that this identity fall outside the gender binary and they suffer discrimination and systematic erasure in society. And sometimes also in online projects, of course. So sometimes there are issues with discrimination also in projects like Wikipedia and Wikidata. This impacts not just people who strictly identify as non-binary, but also trans people in general, intersex people. So there are many communities that are affected by this issue. And anyone who does not conform to the traditional normative Western view of gender is subject to discrimination. We will have a first publication on this subject, which is presents the main results of this study in the Ethics in Linked Data forthcoming book. This will come out next year. But let's start with some common misconceptions about gender and gender representation. This you see here is the gender unicorn. It is a simple scheme that was made to illustrate the complexity of gender identity, gender expression, sex, and also physical and emotional attraction, which are separate from this. So, gender is not easy to model, okay? Many people think that gender is trivial information, that gender is just basic stuff. So you had the date of birth and you had the gender of a person, and that's very simple. It is not simple at all. It is a very complex topic to model. It is not binary, so there are many identities that stand outside the gender binary, male and female. And these non-binary identities are not a new thing, are not ahead of the moment, okay? They have been with us for centuries and centuries. This is true in some non-Western societies. There was talk yesterday about decolonizing Wikidata, and from this point of view, the gender representation that is prevalent is based on Western standards and standards from the global north. But also in Western society itself, non-binary identities have been present in the past, and then at some point throughout the centuries they were erased. I suggest reading this book, The Shape of Sex, that illustrates this very well. There are three research questions that we have considered in this study. The study is ongoing, so we don't have all the results yet. The first is modeling of gender, which is the main issue. How is gender modeled in Wikidata and in the ontology of Wikidata? Then there is the data itself. So what is represented and who is represented? Okay, this is looking more specifically at the data itself. And then there is the discussion about gender by the community. This is also very interesting because it tells us why certain modeling choices have been taken, okay? And why some data have been represented in a certain way. So we are considering all these three questions. What we need to answer these questions? Well, in our opinion, we need, first of all, a complete timeline of gender modeling in Wikidata since the beginning, so 9 years of gender modeling. Then we need accurate statistics about non-binary identities in Wikidata. This is also important. Luckily, this is quite easy to achieve just by running SQL queries on the graph. And then we need a corpus of user discussions about gender to answer the third question about how gender has been discussed, how users have taken some decisions about gender modeling. The property that is used in Wikidata to represent the gender of people is P21. As you probably know, it is one of the most common properties. It is labeled in English sex or gender. This has caused some confusion in the past because there is some ambiguity between the concept of sex and the concept of gender identity. The property was created in the early days of Wikidata, February 2013. Initially, it was labeled only sex, and in other languages, it was labeled only gender. So this was really confusing in the beginning. But then the label of this property was changed in most languages to sex or gender. Initially, the only allowed values for this property were male, female, intersex, and unknown. So there was no concept of non-binary gender identity apart from the representation of intersex people, but this classification is based on sex and not on gender identity. So it is a different thing. Some statistics about P21. These are updated to yesterday. So there is a huge gender gap in the representation of biographical data about people. 82% male and just 18% female, first of all. So 3.3 million male, including 276 trans male. As you know, trans men are men, trans women are women, so we include trans male with male and trans female with female. 700,000 million female. Just 115 intersex people and 645 non-binary. Now, these are very low numbers for these categories, and we believe that they are significantly underrepresented because the prevalence of intersex people is around 1% in the population, and non-binary people are difficult to estimate also, but it is a number close to 1%, or at least between 0.5 and 2% of the population. So these are very, very low numbers. This can be explained in several ways. One reason can be that maybe non-binary identities are not represented accurately. So many non-binary people are actually represented as male or female, or maybe they're simply missing. Looking more specifically at the non-binary class and related classes, we see 481 non-binary, which is a more generic classification. Then there are 37 gender fluid people, 35 gender queer people, 15 two-spirit people, 14 agender people, and then there are many more classes, including bigender, for example, and also some specific classes for some specific communities, such as the two-spirit, which is for Native American communities. 63 other people are represented in different ways. I didn't have space to put them all here, but they will be reported, of course, in every publication that results from this study. How was gender populated in Wikidata? This is a very important question. So, where does the data come from? And this, when we started to look at this from a historical perspective, we saw that at the beginning, the values of P21 were manually annotated. So gender was checked individually by each user, and the user had the responsibility of making sure that the gender information was correct. Some users added sources, some users didn't. Okay, this was not a requirement, but still the user had the responsibility. But then gender started being imported from Wikipedia, and in particular from Wikipedia categories, which in some Wikipedia languages are gendered. However, Wikipedia is not a reliable source, as you know, so this is a bit of an issue. And this was reported at the time, but it was not considered a big problem because of one of the misconceptions reported before, the fact that gender is basic stuff, okay, which is not true. Then gender was imported from external databases, several of them, and it is unclear if this data is actually reliable or not, because in these databases, they do not report the original sources of the data. And then the most problematic thing was when gender started to be imported from personal names. So some people said that female names, only female people use female names, only male people use male names. So this is very problematic because some names are unisex. So you cannot reliably understand if that is a male or female person. There are many, many exceptions, so male people with female names and vice versa. And there are also some cases of names, for example, in our language Italian, Andrea is a male name, but the same name in other languages, Andrea, for example, is a female. So this was quite a mess, as you can imagine, and many errors had to be corrected through the effort of projects that focus on gender representation, especially. Also, there was an idea to import gender from pronouns, so he, him, she, her. This was also very problematic. Luckily, it was not implemented, at least not on a wide scale. But this is also very wrong because there are people who use male pronouns, but they are not male, and there are people who use female pronouns and are not female. And so there is some correlation, but it is not accurate. Okay. Why did people look at all these possible ways to import gender? Why did they need to go through great lengths to fill all these genders? Because of a fundamental need for completeness. So I was there at the beginning in the early years of Wikidata, and I remember these many discussions, not about gender specifically, but about do we need to source every statement and go towards maximum accuracy, but then the knowledge base will be small, or do we need to add every data that we have outside, import everything, and then if there are errors, we will fix them later. In the end, so maximum accuracy or maximum completeness. It is not easy, it is not possible to achieve both at the same time. So for gender, completeness one. The population of gender. Of gender identity in Wikidata reached 70% in 6 months and 95% in 2 years. So there was a significant push for completeness at the expense of accuracy. And this impacted in a disproportionate way marginalized gender identities, such as non-binary identities. Another important issue that affected non-binary identities is gendered properties. So in the early years of Wikidata, some properties were created to represent family relations, and these were gendered. So there was mother and father, brother and sister, uncle and aunt, stepfather and stepmother, and possibly more properties. Some users said, let's not be this specific and put the gender inside the name of the property. Okay, let's try to do something more generic that applies to everyone. So, first of all, uncle and aunt were replaced with relative in 2013. This was not on the basis of gender, but just because they were considered too specific. But then, brother and sister. And stepfather and stepmother were also replaced with sibling and stepparent because people realized that if you have a non-binary sibling, that person is not a brother and it is not a sister, they are not a sister. So, of course, sibling is more general and better at representing everyone. And including everyone. I remember the discussions about this around 2016, and they were very long discussions, and there was a significant opposition to replacing brother and sister with sibling, which has also, I believe, some deep reasons, not only about misconceptions of gender, but also related to the mechanisms through which decisions are taken in Wikidata. What about mother and father? Mother and father, there was a proposal in 2013 to replace them with parent. It was rejected. There was a proposal in 2015 and it was rejected. There was a proposal in 2016 and it was rejected again. And now we still have mother and father, okay. Which is not good in my opinion, but that's my opinion. Another important issue that came up is about the representation of trans people. And it was the source of significant discussions and conflict in the early Wikidata community.
Daniele, sorry to interrupt you, but we have 5 minutes left.
Yes, I have just, oh, sorry.
Don't
I have
worry.
just one slide and then I'm finished. Okay. So I'll just go quickly through this. The case of Chelsea Manning was the initial case that sparked discussions about trans people. There were significant issues with the naming, there were edit wars, there was some transphobia on in the discussions. There were wrong definitions of what a trans person is. And there was also some erasure of trans women and trans men, which were not recognized for the initial 2 years as women and men in the model. So trans woman was not a subclass of woman, and trans man was not a subclass of men, and this was a problem. Where we are today in this study? We have completed, not 100%, but almost completed the timeline of gender modeling in Wikidata. We have collected statistics. And now Chiara will discuss briefly the corpus of user discussions about gender that we are building. Sorry for being late.
Don't worry.
You should have presentation rights.
Yeah, okay.
Can you see the icon?
Yeah, and they say that I need to furnish the, I don't know, okay.
It's loading. Perfect.
Okay. So I'm going to be very quick, and I'm going to present a part of the preliminary corpus analysis on gender identities in Wikidata. So how Daniele introduced during previously, they answered to two questions, the data questions and the modeling question. But I'm going to give you a glimpse about how we try to answer to the community questions. So how the Wikidata community has handled the evolution toward a more inclusive non-binary representation. And we want to do a corpus analysis, and for doing a corpus analysis, we need a corpus. So we are building a corpus of an English corpus of Wikidata discussions about gender identities and their representation in the Wikidata and the Wikidata knowledge base called Wigita EN, Wikidata Gender Talks English. Why a corpus analysis? We want to do a corpus analysis. Corpus analysis techniques are very widespread in linguistics. I'm a linguist. I'm a PhD in linguistics, and but also in humanities and science in general, because we want to keep track of the narrative about gender identities in the Wikidata community. We want to see how the narrative changed during time, and we want to study the impact of the LGBTQ plus movements on the Wikidata community and how they had could bring awareness in a Wikidata discussion. Also, we would like with this corpus to detect cases of hate speech, sexism, misgendering, and so on. For now, we are at the half of the work, and we have 26 relevant discussions for almost 300,000 tokens. I'm going to be very quick, so in how we build the corpus. So we crawled the discussion from the Wikipedia API. We looked just for some key terms that you can see here, and we just researched on four namespaces, so talk, property talk, Wikidata talk, and Wikidata. This raw corpus, that is a set of non-filtered discussion, has been semi-automatic annotated, so we manually filtered the discussion that for us are relevant. And for us, a relevant discussion is a discussion that has as a main topic the gender and its representation. And then there are some cases where this gender is discussed indirectly, and then we filtered manually for this reason. And we used a web page interface that Daniele implemented for the corpus. that is this one that you can see, where we can choose is if the discussion is relevant, not relevant, or not in English, or if it was not a discussion. And then we're gonna have our corpus. So to be also quick on the criteria, why we choose English? Because this is a preliminary analysis, so we didn't want to go through all the languages. We speak English, but we are Italian, so this is going to be too much for a preliminary corpus. And then English, the Wikidata English community is the biggest one, so there are more data to work on. Also, we also include some metadata, such as namespace, page, discussion title, time details, user in the discussion. But we didn't include the contents and documentation section on the page, the multilingual discussions, discussion where the gender and the sex was not related to humans. So when they talk, when in discussion was talking about animals, botanics, we discard them. This is a case study, but I think we are running late, but it's about the case of the agenda names that Daniele was talking before. And our analysis, what we want to do with this corpus is actually a time narrative of gender identities in Wikidata communities, so how the narrative of gender identities evolved during time, so if it increased or decreased using some distribution semantics models, and a cluster analysis about the gender identities discussed among the members of Wikidata, focusing on how language is used in the gender representation narrative. And also, but not in this work, we want to analyze if there are cases of hate speech and misgendering using the topic modeling analysis